Good morning and welcome in for another video. Myself, Darren, HGV Class 1 driver here in the UK. And the time for today's start is 4:30 in the morning. Okay, the vehicle check's done. Make sure there's no damage on the vehicle. Tire tread is in good condition. No damage to the wheel nuts. And no damage to any Suzy's, tank or anything else on the vehicle. For today, I've got two jobs booked. So the first one is over in Scunthorpe and the second one is in Doncaster. But first of all, I need to go down to the hub so I can get loaded up with the pallets what need to be delivered for the day. Dinner placed away. Fridge for the day. To get to Scunthorpe from where I am at the moment is just straight up the M62, past Leeds and then carrying it down. It's 104 miles and with traffic, I'm looking at about 2.5 hours drive. On the M62 at the moment, and the time is just gone at 6 o'clock. The ETA is 8 o'clock, so I'm still making quite good time. And if the traffic stays the way it is at the moment, there shouldn't be any issues whatsoever. Hopefully we're early enough to set off as well to get past Leeds at a good time before traffic starts building up from there. I'm going to say about 20 to 7, I think I'll end up around Leeds area, give or take. Pretty glad I'm not having to use the M1 this morning. Traffic now you can see going past on the far left two lanes. That's probably been like that for about 3 or 4 miles, give or take. Quite surprised though, there's nobody in this lane trying to jump in last minute. Oh, I couldn't have timed that any better, could I? Generally could not have timed that any better. The skies look nice and clear this morning as well, so it looks like it might be quite a nice day later on. Still quite chilly, but I don't mind it too much. Traffic looks fairly heavy above, but I think it's moving at least. I think it's just the traffic lights really on the actual roundabout which is causing a lot of backlog. I've still got 48 miles left to go and about 1 hour left on driving. It's currently 7 a.m. If the traffic stays like this all the way there, I wouldn't be too bad, it'd be alright, wouldn't it? If you've got any questions about the vlog or HGV driving, let me know down below in comments. I'll try my best to answer as many as I can. Before I do forget, I'd like to give a nice little shout out as well to William, one of our long time subscribers. So thanks very much for watching, mate, I really do appreciate the support. And for everybody as well and new to the channel, again thank you for supporting the channel, I really do appreciate it. Leaving the M1 for junction 35 and I'm going to be following it down the M18 now to go towards Scunthorpe. Been a fairly nice drive this morning. So far so good, touch wood. Really good sign though, is it? Road works down here. Hopefully it's just on the slip road area. The sun is really low though. Got the little sun visor right down at the moment. to invest in a pair of sunglasses, a little cheap pair. It's always worth keeping some in your truck. Just that slip road, the road works, which is good. 24 miles still to go. It's pretty much straight down here, I think. For at least the next 6 miles, anyhow. Arrived now at the first job, all booked in. I've just got to wait for the class 2 driver to finish off unloading. Once he goes, I can then move into the yard, get unloaded myself, and then off to Doncaster. Doncaster job is 26 miles away and about 50 minutes driving, give or take. Managed to pop into Home Bargains as well, picked up some polish, some air fresheners, and some cockpit shine. I'm not too sure what this is like. If you use this before, let me know. I couldn't find anything for the chrome to try and keep that clean on the outside for the tank. Got a little rag for the outside, and then I've got some microfiber ones as well for the internal. As one comes out, one goes in. Careful of the forklift where he is. There's 10 pallets coming off at this place, so it shouldn't really take too long to do. That yard is a little bit tighter than I thought, to be honest. Quickly remove the straps first of all, so they can start getting unloaded at least. It's that time of year again already, where the night heat has to come on. Not real too sure here, what's going on? It's like the midway through, trying to close one of the lanes. And then, yeah, there was no access for me to get into this middle section at the time, so the guy was just running down towards me. Like, don't go forward, mate. I can't really, bud. There's cones all over the place. Miles to go then until my destination over at Doncaster. Quite an easy one to get there. I'm currently on the 1077, and then I need to jump onto one of the motorways. I can't think which one it is off the top of my head, so I might be wrong here, but I think it's the M180. I'm gonna guess the M180. Yeah, but actually I think we got it right there. And then taking that straight down into Doncaster, pretty much. Nice and straightforward trip. Quick stop off for a break over at Hatfield Services on the way down to Doncaster. Treat myself to a cheeky sausage roll from Greg's. About to approach 10:30 and I'm 2.5 miles away from our second destination. So we should be there in the next 10, 15 minutes, give or take. Off the top of my head, I think there's 10 pallets to get taken off of this one. I'm not too sure if it's going to be a back door tip or if it's going to be a side tip with forks. First time visiting this place, so I'm a little bit unsure. And just continuing now towards Barnby Dun. Hope you all had a great weekend as well. Pretty quiet one for myself, didn't really do too much. Nice relaxing Saturday. And Sunday as well, actually. I didn't think I'd done anything yesterday either. It's one of the downsides of power starting at 4 o'clock in the morning on a Monday. I need to be asleep for about 7 o'clock in the evening on a Sunday, so I can get plenty of rest. Slept really well last night as well, actually. I think I must have needed it. Straight down this road for another mile, and then I'm going to be taking the left down onto Doncaster Road. Funny enough, actually,
I have been to this estate before, so I recognise this part of the road. Well, I've just not been to the business that I'm delivering to. So I'm looking for Kirk Sandal Industry Estate. Should be down here. Yeah, it's a bit weird actually. Probably about 2 years ago last time I came down this area. Didn't recognise any of it until just went over that little bridge then. I was like, ah, I know where I am. Been here once before. Got this area anyhow. Yards to the right. Oh, not these lights, a little bit after. So if I can remember correctly, I think that might be the only way in and out is across that little bridge. So I think there's a lot of low bridges around this region. Rightio then, so keep an eye out for the business I could be delivering to. Side. Perfect. Can I get in this way? Yeah, just make sure it's not just a car park for customers or anything. It looks like there's a gate at the side. So I need to take it a little bit wide, swing it out, come back round. Let's keep an eye on the passenger side. Go park it here as well, so it's out of the way. I'm not really too sure where to go, to be honest, and hopefully there's lots of space down at the end to turn around. So take it nice and slow, just in case there's any forklift drivers popping around. Oh, it opens up quite a bit actually at the end, doesn't it? Which is good. Ah, goods inwards there. Take it nice and wide, spin it round, and then I'll go try and find a forklift driver who can unload me. Managed to speak with the FLT driver, so the plan of action, pull over on one side, do one side of the curtain, and then move over, do the other side. Trailers are nice and secure and ready for the journey back home, which happens to be 93 miles away and about a 2 hour drive. Actually, scrap that, because we've got a collection round, hopefully in the area of Doncaster, to take back towards Warrington for then a delivery for tomorrow, or it could be directly to the client today. And the reason why I sound a little bit vague on that is because I'm not actually too sure on where I'm going to be making the collection from or where it's going to. I'm still waiting for the job to come through at the moment. So I'm just going to pull over somewhere nice and safe, hang fire until the office know what exactly I'm going to be doing, and then off I go. Job finally come through. And the collection is over in Rotherham, 21 miles away, and it's a full trailer of 26 pallets to get collected, and then it's going back to our yard to get dispatched for tomorrow. So the postcode is S63. If you know Rotherham. very rare actual do a collection or delivery at Rotherham. So it's gonna be another new place delivering to. Well, collecting from, shall I say. Should be there in about 40 minutes according to the sat nav. It's been a nice and easy shift, hasn't it, today for a Monday? Two drops done before 11 o'clock. And the third one's a collection, which will be there before 12. Jobs are good, in. Wish every Monday was this easy, being honest with you. I know if I was driving down to London starting at the same time, I wouldn't even be at the first drop yet. Normally around 11:30, is it, I get to the first job. Obviously depending whereabouts in London it is. That's quite cool. A little Halloween had decorated house, isn't it? You don't see a lot of houses, do you, getting like really fancy decorated done for Halloween. It's quite good, don't you, do see them. Good for the kids, isn't it? Do it right here, 150 yards. A little blind turn here, isn't it? So I just need to keep an eye on traffic coming. Straight down on the motorway. Can't remember which motorway it was, but it's the one that goes down and around Doncaster to come up at Rotherham. I'll let you know when I get there. Well, you never go and guess what's just happened. I just arrived at the place with the postcode, and there was a guy outside having a cig. I was like, yeah mate, do you know where this business is, mate? He goes, yeah, it used to be here 9 years ago. I was like, all right, great. So they've moved then, have they? But luckily, I do believe it is just here. So it's only like 100 yards away. It's not massively out the way. So this is the direction that he's given me for where they might actually be now. Fields End Business Park I'm looking for. That doesn't look like it. That looks like a business, not a business park. Ooh, I'm not sure actually. There's quite a lot of looking on sat-nav on the overview. It looks like there could be quite a lot of low bridges, etc., around here, so I need to be careful. Same for weight limits. Oh, that's not right. So, if I go straight down here, it could take me back onto that main road. And I just need to try and find somewhere safe to pull over whilst the office try and get a bit more information. Right, so then I've got a bit more information now. Put over, done a bit of Google mapping and lay-by. And it should be on here. Should be in the key word. Oh, that looks like it's going into a car park. That generally looks like it's going into a car park. What I'm going to do, I'm going to reverse it back a little bit, and then I'm going to have a walk in, because I don't fancy getting stuck in there. I'll try and get a better idea then, where I need to be going. Last thing I want to do is get stuck in a car park. It's alright. Looks like there's a cut through there as well. Says we're walking all the way around, which is good. Hazard lights on, enough space for any prams or wheelchairs that need to get past, and away we get out and check.
In doubt, just get out and have a walk around. This is the area I don't really want to bring a class one unit into, definitely.
Still can't locate it anywhere, so what I'm going to do is go to a couple of these units, which are across the way, some of these bigger ones, and I'll see. Oh, there you go. So the place I'm looking for is called Carlton, and there it is, very, very small next to Euromix. At least we found it in the end. Now I just need to turn the unit around, probably go reverse into there, and then straight down to the other place. And to be honest with you, it probably doesn't help things that we've been given the name Carlton as the business address. However, if they put CPI, which is huge letters, as soon as you drive down here, I would have seen it straight away. So I don't know why they give us the part of it instead of the whole thing, or CPI. Nicely reversed onto the bay. Because of the weight of it all, straps are going to be needed for today. All done at Rotherham, and the time is currently 1:45. It's a 2 hour and a little bit drive to get back to Warrington from where I am now. All I have to do is jump on the A1M, jump on 62, straight down East Lancs, jobs are good. And I've all got 10 pallets loaded on at the moment, so I might see if they want anything collecting on the way back. So then I can get, say, another 12 pallets on the way back in, drop that off at the hub. Then hopefully that'll be around 4 o'clock, nearer to the finish time, instead of getting there at 2 o'clock and having 4 hours to play about with. Postcode originally had taken me to that place just there. So it's not exactly a million miles away from where I am now. I kind of forgotten about the roadworks on the A1M at the moment. So they're doing bridge repairs. And yeah, you can see it's backed up quite a bit, not really moving too much either. Looks absolutely lovely again now, doesn't it, in the afternoon. It's currently 2:15 at the moment, still got another hour to go. The A1M put me back quite a bit for some time, really. A little bit of traffic coming past Leeds as well. Bradford's not been too bad. As you can see now, the rest of the motorway on the M62 is looking pretty good. Makes a nice change. It's absolutely roasting at the moment. That sun is so warm, beaming through the window at the moment. Feels like it's summer again. It's really not wanting to turn to winter, is it, for too long. Real bad rain, wasn't it, at the start of the week, last week. It's just gone back to this lovely weather again. Take over.
there. Only got about 12 ton on at the moment. Struggling a little bit getting up this hill. Currently doing 46 miles per hour, foot flat down. Just coming over the moors at the moment. And some nice views up here as well. You got the sun beaming through the clouds, trying to light everything up. It's quite nice. And just approaching the highest point of the motorway in England, supposedly anyway. Saddleworth Moors, that's the name of the place. There's a little pub right by the reservoir. I don't know if anybody's ever visited it. I've always wanted to try and go, but looks like it's closed at the moment, so I don't know if it's closed down or not. Does anyone know if it's still open? If you know the area, you know which pub I'm probably talking about anyway, because it's driving over the motorway in the M62. You can just see the big reservoir and there's that nice big pub thing right on the verge of it. Otherwise, it'd be like a needle in a haystack, wouldn't it? I'm still yet as well to spend the night up here. I really want to try and do it one time. So if I'm on the way back from, say, up north, and travelling down this way, running out of hours, I might just pull over on this junction coming up. I think there's a couple of laybys that you can set off at. Quite cool that, staying out there. Just exiting the M62 now, 5 to 3, still got 20 minutes left to go. By the time I dropped the trailer in the yard, etc., got sorted out, probably looking at about 3:30, 3:20 to 4. Fingers crossed for a nice early finish. I don't want to jinx myself just yet, because I always jinx myself. I have a real bad habit of doing this, don't I? I always go, yeah, that's been done, should be right back. No problems. And then I get a phone call. On your way back in, could you just nip? The good old classic saying, isn't it? Could you just nip? And then before you know it, it's 2 hours added onto your day. Luckily, it's a nice and easy job though, isn't it, doing driving? And it's lucky you love it.
Back at the yard, it's currently 3:40, and I've got one little job left to do. So I need to drop this trailer, go to the hub, pick a trailer which is already loaded up, and then bring it back here. Then job's done. Hopefully, I'll be finishing back here for 4:45 latest. Back at the yard now, 4:30, so what I'm going to be doing, I've got this like little squeegee thing that came with the truck, and also it's got another attachment for an ice scraper, so it's quite handy really. So I'm going to give it a nice little scrub on the top windows. Well, that's a little bit better. At least I can actually see now. For some reason, the window wiper couldn't get 2 or 3 little bugs, so I just had to give it a scrub. And just like that, I'm back at the yard, finished up, for 4:30 just gone. So that is quite a good day for a Monday, if I say so myself. Nice and easy, down Doncaster and back. No hassle, no messing about. It's the way you want it every day. And now I'm just hoping for the same thing for tomorrow. Tomorrow is a 5 o'clock in the morning start, and it's going to be one trip straight down to Northampton, booked in for 9 o'clock. So I've got 4 hours then from start of work, sort the vehicle out, and get myself right down there with no problems. Hopefully, fingers crossed on that one. Should everything go to plan, that should be me hopefully having a nice finish tomorrow as well. Fingers crossed again on that one. For the time being, I am going to call it a day on the video, so thanking you very much for watching, and thank you for all the new subscribers, likes, comments, and everything else. I really do appreciate it. So have a great day, have a great week, and as always, stay safe out there. Bye for now.